second seed. See, down at the bottom of the page, Richmond and St. Mary's will play the second game here. The other first and second round games in New Orleans. Mike Rice in his third season as head coach at Robert Morris, located as a suburb of Pittsburgh. And the starting lineups on your left for Robert Morris: Jones, Abraham, Unwigwe, Robinson, and Green. A couple of changes on the right. Wayans and Stokes are starting for Scotty Reynolds and Corey Fisher. It's a minor infraction, and we'll get to that in just a second. Here's Jay Wright in his ninth season as Villanova head coach. You see Scotty Reynolds talking with him and Corey Fisher. Jay told Bill Raftery that they are not starting, but they'll see action almost immediately.
Exactly. Not upset with them at all. Just a teaching point, basically. Got to get the head in it, and he's just alerting the club to follow suit.
Gary Maxwell, Rick Crawford, and Bruce Bell are the officials. And today's game is brought to you in HDTV by LG. Life's good. Robert Morris, Northeast Conference. Villanova, Big East Conference. And the tip controlled by the Colonials.
And Vern Lundquist, Villanova Goose. We'll be seeing that a few times this week.
Dalton Jones is the point guard. This is Unwigwe, number two. And Karan Abraham heads to his left, turnover, and it'll be Villanova ball.
Now, the confusing thing with Villanova is they mix it up. They don't mind switching, having small guys play large people. They'll trap. You got to be very alert.
Here's Malik Wayans, a freshman, starting in place of Scotty Reynolds. Entry pass immediately down low. Yaru, who gives them a lot of height at 6'10", and he gets the first basket.
And Jay will be Yaruing all day if that keeps up. They love those inside points. He's a talent. Next couple of years, he will blossom. Here's that trap, Hearn.
That's Pena out to help with it. Left side, here's Karan Abraham, number four. Unwigwe, number two, a little pump fake and rebound down and a foul.
I think it might be Green over the back there. Dallas trying to attack the glass.
It was number 24, Dallas Green. Scotty Reynolds up. And again, this is something it had to do with a question they failed to answer on a scouting report.
Well, I think what he asked was, who's announcing today's game? And I'm on Scotty's side. Why should he know?
They were clueless.
Well, you know, the one thing about Jay, he just really embraces these kids. And I think it's part of understanding. And this, see, if Scotty had seen this graphic, he'd know who's announcing.
Well, they're trying to remind us who we are. A minute and 10 seconds gone. Oh, my goodness. So it's going to be that kind of a week.
As long as the basketball meets this lofty standard.
Nice pick and roll, but Yaru can't hang on to the pass from Wayans. Hell ball, and the possession arrow goes Villanova way.
And what Mike Rice does is play great man-to-man defense. They really understand how to jam things up to help their partner. You don't get here unless you can compete, and they certainly do. He has raised this program, knocking them down the last 3 years.
Reggie Redding will inbound for the Wildcats. And there's Pena. He's traveling.
Trying to use their size, though. Nice little lob to Pena. And you can see everybody down there raking for Robert Morris.
Unwigwe will inbound it out of Hyattsville, Maryland, number two. Gets it in the hands of Dalton Jones. Here's the slight pressure applied by Reggie Redding.
Nice help, Pena.
Stolen. Right side, Redding gets it. Knocked out of bounds. And a foul is called again. Dalton Jones.
Well, they scrap, don't they, on that end?
Indeed.
They're going over trying to find themselves. They struggled late in the season, as you well know, Vern.
Well,
that spark, maybe.
Yeah. Why do you think, Cap?
Well, I just think you get comfortable. The coaches use the word fat. Well, you know, you're
right.
Just think it's going to come easily. Nice D.
Wigway all the way off the glass. Put back is good. That's Dallas Green, number 24.
Nice run under the floor by the big guy. He's got pretty good body control in that low post. Does a nice job of getting free off of penetration. We haven't seen it yet, but the perimeter guys and Robert Morris really get in the lane, get a foot there.
Pena takes the jumper just inside the arc, in and out. Dallas Green with a rebound.
And they just want to hang tough, the old four-minute story. Be in touch each 4 minutes.
Unwigwe, that's Messier. Unwigwe, Belton Jones, taken away. Malik Wayans, one-on-one, and he will drive all the way to the basket and put it off the glass and good.
Scotty who? Who needs Scotty? Wayans, a really promising player, great talent, great speed in the open floor. He is a jet. Look at the body control. Able to, a little kiss at the end, but solid defensive play.
And the first man off the bench is Taylor King, not Scotty Reynolds, not Corey Fisher. And Russell Johnson, number 34, makes his first appearance on the court for Robert Morris.
Well, Taylor knew who the announcers were. He came over early. Acknowledged us.
Yeah.
Quite a personality. At a Duke and now at Villanova. He's an aggressive player.
Maurice Sutton on. Well, Yeru will sit. Redding King, Sutton, Stokes on the floor for Villanova.
And all this scrambling and automatic switching can be very confusing. You're going to have to use your individual ability frequently to beat people.
Russell Johnson is Sutton to stymie the shot, and that's out of bounds. Touch last by Villanova.
You know, Russell Johnson, the guy that can use that pull-up jumper, gets on that offensive glass. A very confident team.
Inbounds, Abraham.
But the Villanova looks very fresh on the defensive end, Vern. Look at the reaction, challenging.
Well,
a little bit late on Abraham.
That's a three. Abraham's 81st made three of the year. Freshman record for Robert Morris, the Colonials.
Rookie of the year in the NEC Northeastern.
Well, they won their way into this event by defeating Quinnipiac in the championship game. He had 16 points in that one. There is the pure stroke of Taylor King.
That's what they need. I mean, that's his game. Any pick and pop, he can really stretch defense, open up the driving lanes for others.
Scotty Reynolds at the scoring table, getting ready to come on the floor. And here's Belton Jones, number three. This is a Robert Morris team that comes in with a 23-11 record. Steps traveling. Dead ball. Scotty Reynolds on the floor for Malik Wayans.
What a year this guy's had, Scotty. I mean, just outstanding. Everybody has his number, and they challenge him every game, and he just lights it up. Great leadership qualities. 4 years, understands the deal.
And named the first team All-American by the United States Basketball Writers Association a week or so ago. That'll be the first of many honors for him this year.
Isn't that great? Pays to hang in there. What, that pump fake, people still bite.
Long attempted three by Reggie Redding. That's off the front rim. 7-5, Villanova leads.
Nice crossover.
That's Josiah Whitehead, number 44, getting increased playing time here in the last six or seven games. Sutton with the high screen.
Nice.
Pick and roll, there he is. Nice.
And nobody underneath to defend. Just great deployment, real understanding of how to stay wide, Vern.
15:28 to go in the opening half. Time called. Wildcats lead.
Dallas Green must have had blood on his left arm there.
Oh, is that right?
You see the... here.
What's up, Joan? We welcome you back to Providence, Rhode Island. Run your fantasy baseball league with the award-winning Fantasy Baseball Commissioner. Try it for free at cbssports.com/commissioner. Corey Fisher, who did not start today, along with Scotty Reynolds because of a minor teaching point, stress minor.
Yeah, I'm
Jay Wright trying to make a point.
I'm sorry, Vern. I'm going to have to tell Jay, you don't ask questions, you know?
As a coach?
Yeah.
Yeah, you don't want to know that they don't know the answer.
Right, in case they're not sure, you don't embarrass anybody. Gary Wallace on the floor with the ball, Vern. Good shooter, 40% threes. A lot of dribble drive, and you're going to have to turn the corner. It's a very scrappy defense right now. You can see everybody collecting around the ball, and the piece stays the same way.
That'll be Robert Morris' ball. The Colonials, they were a junior college up until 1976, made the leap immediately from JC to Division I, so they have been Division I participants for 34 years. Located on the suburbs, in the suburbs, Moon Township. That's for three, and that's Abraham.
And that was from Moon Township, too.
Yes.
He can fill it up deep, can he? You know, I recruited there years ago when it wasn't junior college. Gus Kropp was the coach. You know, they had great success in those days, too. And now a fine university.
Enrollment 5,000 in the NCAAs for the second year in a row. And Abraham cans one from Moon Township a second time.
You got to watch Abraham during the Lennon season.
11-9, Robert Morris with the lead. Back-to-back three.
He can light it up. He loves to step into those threes.
And here's Scotty Reynolds. Sutton with the high screen. King is open. They can't quite get the ball to him. Here's Sutton. Good defense. Pulls it away, and it's a rebound, Robert Morris.
Playing a little confidence right now.
Wow.
Not a good one here.
No.
Going to the well a little too deep, but they're coming up with the loose things. How about the three? Just a little bump here. Vern just sets everything up. Just solid. A good understanding of how to position yourself. And how about the catch and shoot? I mean, he gets himself prepared beautifully. And this is number two. That's that ability to step in, and you can't give him that time and distance. Good ball movement.
Mike Rice goes to his bench again. He's got Brad Peel, number 25, on the floor for the first time. This is Peel setting the screen. How about that nice defense by Pena? But another open three off the rim. Rebound offense up and in.
Well, they are scrapping. Huh? New Wigway having trouble with that deep one, but they have been banging the glass.
Russell Johnson gets that one, and it's an 8-0 Robert Morris run.
Nice pump. Boy, does he do a great job of that, getting people in the air.
Around the world and out, and the rebound goes to Josiah Whitehead, number 44.
And they push it up, try and get something early, and then a lot of ball screens.
Delton Jones comes left. Unwigwe.
Nice steal. Oh, the kick. Unintentional.
Robert Morris has it.
They're getting everything going their way because they're scrappy.
Jones, nowhere to go.
Pick it up.
Over and back. Now, Robert Morris, the Colonials. Moon Township near the Pittsburgh Airport out of the Northeast Conference. 7th NCAA. And Hank Fraley, player in the NFL, one of their notable alums. And Robert Morris was a signer of the Declaration of Independence.
Dear friend of yours, wasn't he?
I knew him well.
Hey, by the way,
I knew him as Bob.
Bob, you were that tight. You had hoagies with him downtown, huh? You know, they ran the five-star basketball camp at Rama. They had some of the finest players in the history of basketball on that campus at one time or another.
Uh-huh.
You know, the Jordans and et cetera.
Right. That one knocked out of bounds, and it'll be Villanova ball. They trail by four as Robert Morris has scored eight unanswered. Malik Wayans is going to come back on for Corey Fisher.
You know, Mike Rice's name's being thrown around now. Anytime you have a little run of success, of course, his alma mater, Fordham, and a lot of jobs opening for better or worse reasons,
yes,
right?
Boy, indeed.
Offense with the scoop.
Wednesday on a special night of Survivor, both the heroes and villains will go to Tribal Council. It's an all-new Survivor Wednesday only on CBS.
Sort of the beginning, like American U last year for Villanova.
It is, isn't it?
Yeah, just struggling to navigate. They made the final four. A long way to go in this one, but having their difficulties.
Russell Johnson had the ball in his hands, gets it to Belton Jones, a redshirt freshman out of Philadelphia. Of course, the location of Villanova. Jumper peel. Short. Nice. Rebound ready.
Nice look he had, though.
Malik Wayans, you really like his upside.
Oh, he is a talent. Explosive. He's got strength. Kyle Lowry-like.
For the floater, not good. Yaru can't get the rebound. And no, he does get the loose change.
And, you know, it was the ability of Wayans to stay active. Got a piece of the ball.
Under 12 now, Muftau Yaru from Benin got the last one.
Well, he's going to be a big-time player someday.
Right? Think so?
Yeah, the more he plays in each game is what Jay says. Nice hands here. Played by Redding.
Redding finds Scotty Reynolds. Jumper. Air ball. And a time called with 11:32 to go in the first half.
You keep active. Good things seem to happen. Look at Wayne. Scrappy getting the piece of it. The strong finish. Yabru! We'll be right back.
really like.
Really a nice start for Robert Morris. Out rebounding Villanova at this point, 10-2. Jay Wright, ninth season as a head coach of the Wildcats. Previous stint at Hofstra, and he's a graduate of Bucknell. Taylor King goes for the steal, right?
Tommy Picoro, who took over at Hofstra, another name that's being thrown around in that metropolitan area for jobs. His longtime assistant, Jay, very fond of him and his ability. These kids are ready, aren't they, Robert Morris? They're handling traps, and he switches. There's a double and a spread.
Wigway with the shot clock under 10. Jumper no good. Rebound, Yaru. Rob Robinson's back on the floor now for Robert Morris as well. Comes out to trap, and here's Yaru. Spin move, runs right into Dallas Green. King can't hang on to it. Out of bounds, touch last by Robert Morris.
Love the way they're attacking Robert Morris. That's why they're on the glass, Fern.
Well, so far, both teams 5 of 12, but 3 of those efforts have come from beyond the arc, and turnovers 8 to 4. The big rebounding edge is what has helped sustain this Robert Morris lead.
Robert Morris very concerned about turnovers because you can score. They would rather a dead ball situation and get back on defense.
Wayne Sledding, nice slip. Yes, it was. And then he misses the shot, does Taylor King.
Now they do a nice job of analyzing when to slip. A lot of times it's a pick and pop with King, but Robert Morris in preparing Villanova, they're tough to prepare for because it's done with the dribble more often than not. It's not like a series of screens. It puts a lot of pressure on your communication skills.
Mentioned to Robert Morris, 15-3 in Northeast Conference play. They wound up tied in regulation conference play with a 15-3 mark with Quinnipiac, and then defeated them in the title game at Quinnipiac, the championship game on the road. And Tom Moore, the head coach, the former UConn assistant. That team had been undefeated at home 14-0 this year.
Yeah, well, he's done a great job there. New Wigway with his second clean look. Well, those are big. You got to knock them down when you get the opportunity.
Wayans, number 5. Here's Scotty Reynolds. Redding.
Nice hands.
Yes, it was. Belton Jones. Here's Reynolds, squares up, in and out, and Yaru over the top.
Twice Scotty's been on the money, not converting.
All day tomorrow on the CBS College Sports Network, catch live look-ins, expert analysis, and more on NCAA March Madness Central, engineered by GMC Sierra. Dominic Cheek has come on now, number 23. And Corey Stokes is back on the floor as well. There's Cheek, number 23. Another of those McDonald's All-Americans.
Boy, that little trap. If you could turn and attack, Green didn't settle. He could have got himself a fast break situation. 3-on-2.
Pretty power.
How about that? We haven't called that name at all, Robinson.
No, no, no. Robinson, yeah. His first 2 points, and it's a 4-point edge again. With 9:15 to go, first half.
Robinson, he's amazing. He really gets free. Crossover, beat the guy, nothing at the rim.
Wow. With a shot. Yes, indeed. Here's Belton Jones on the run out, left side. Robinson back outside. Abraham, he's hit 3. Misses this one, and it goes right to Pena. Boy, he had a good look. Scotty Reynolds.
Good kick.
Cheek, no.
Not finishing plays, are they, Villanova?
No, no, no.
And that's part of the deal. The understanding of how to get to the rim. Just reading things. Here's the power game. Just strong. Tell you what, he's got the new dude, too, from the championship game in the conference, right? Tough to recognize.
Well, this Villanova team, Bill, 5 of 16 from the field so far. So right around 30%. Gary Wallace has the ball in his hands. Looks back at Mike Rice, his coach. There's the screen set by Robinson. Pick and roll.
A nice recovery by Fisher.
Yes, it was.
Closes the turnover. And how about that?
The quick hands and
down underneath a grab, not necessarily Pena on the floor.
Wow.
Johnson, huh? Is that him?
Let's see who they got.
Robinson. So on the floor now for Villanova, Corey Stokes, Corey Fisher, Pena, Cheek, and Sutton, as Jay Wright tries to find a combination that might work.
Finish. Okay. Right, they're doing a lot of good things. It's just ringing the bell.
Not a good look.
No. At the Robert Morris end, blocking foul is called on Fisher. Well, Robert Morris, we've mentioned Moon Township. It's a suburb of Pittsburgh. And Robert Morris, one of five Pennsylvania teams in. Pitt, of course, is in the big dance. Lehigh, the 16th seed. Villanova and Temple, the Owls, playing Cornell tomorrow. Graham Dunphy wasn't very happy about that.
How about that matchup? Well, it's his dear friend, a longtime associate of 10 years, Steve Donahue. And plus, Cornell's very good.
Yeah, that's
add that to the mix.
Now, one of the more noteworthy losses this year was Cornell's at Kansas in Lawrence at the Fog. They gave the Jayhawks a handful midseason.
They gave a lot of people a handful. Not Penn, though, in the Palestra.
No.
Just fell asleep that night. You know, that Moon Township, somebody old named Chuck Knox, that area, Alec Clipper, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, it is.
Schmidt, remember the great linebacker with the Lions? Am I aging myself a little bit?
No, you're not. Not in my presence. Well, Tony Dorsett from Aliquippa. Mike Ditka.
Later.
Beaver Falls.
Yeah.
Fisher stripped. He's got a man. There he is. Whoa, nice block. Get it back outside. And Abraham pump fake.
They play it. And play with confidence, Robert
They're
Morris.
Quick, aren't they?
Oh, very quick.
Yeah. Alert. With a six-point lead, 7:25 to go.
They're having trouble with that situation there. Anytime they bring two people together, they're having a difficulty.
A little out of control, back outside, jumper, no.
Now they got. Let's see who they got. They could get a bunch of people on this particular play.
I think
either Whitehead or down in the corner, maybe Gary Wallace.
It is Gary Wallace. And time has been called.
A lot of coaches use these games for example.
Ha! Ha! Ha!
That's a first.
...17-11 with 7:15 to go. Villanova down by 6 will inbound. Scotty Reynolds, who is 0 for 3, tries to shake loose. Corey Fisher having trouble getting it in. And finally finds Redding. Skip pass. Reynolds for 3.
Wow.
0 for 4.
Yeah, I mean, he is really unerring this year on those looks. They are struggling. They're not ringing the bell whatsoever. Close to the rim misses. Open jump shots. And some pretty good offense. Unfortunately here, Gary Wallace, I believe number 2 with the discard.
Coming up on AT&T at the half, Greg Gumbel and company will take you out for a live look at the action going on in the NCAA tournament. And they'll get you caught up on all the latest tournament news, plus an AT&T Naismith watch update. That's all coming up on AT&T at the half. Now let's check the 5 on the floor for the Wildcats of Villanova. Fisher and Reynolds, Cheek number 23, Yaru number 13, and Redding number 15.
A real lack of points lately, and shot not a good one there, but they are just struggling. What's it, 5 minutes now without ringing the bell?
One field goal in the last 8.5 minutes. They are 5 of 19 and missed their last 8 shots.
Almost tight. You get that feeling? With
a
the release?
Little bit,
that was a pull the string job by Redding.
Well, they slumped so badly at the end. They were at one point 20-1 for the year. The only loss was to Temple. And then they finished the season 2-5 in their last 7, losing to Marquette in the Big East tournament.
And the margin of losses, very low. So just off your game a little pressure. Pretty good move, huh? The big fella, Whitehead, just sliding, planting those feet.
6'8 senior out of Portsmouth, Virginia. And it's an 8-point Robert Morris lead, 19-11. You see the Robert Morris field goal attempt, 7 of 17. Reynolds is fouled.
A nice cut with Redding with the pass. And look at these numbers, huh? A little turnabout. Of course, the end of the season, some of the teams they were playing were taking aim at them. Either they were upset at their success, but
you remember this, don't you?
I sure do. I sure do. I think the whole country remembers that. And they, right now they're in the same position. A team that's hungry, well prepared, well coached.
Corey Stokes on for Villanova, replacing Dominic Cheek. And Nwegwe is back on now. That's spelled N-W-I-G-W-E, Nwegwe.
Somewhere in America, Mike Rice Sr. is watching this game.
That's right.
This is just what I told you, son. That's how I want you to coach him. They have a great job coaching at Duquesne, and now with the Portland Trailblazers doing some...
He's doing radio television.
Yeah, radio TV. He's been there for a long time. Something like 19 years. Nice play. That's the way to attack that pressure. Once you get over the initial trap, exploit it. Boy, are they prepared.
Yes, indeed. And it just strikes me that the longer this goes on, the more confident they become.
I would agree with you. And that step through, you know, they've walked through this, rehearsed it, understood it. The nice little giveaway at the end. Nwegwe. Mizier.
Foul is on Yaru. And Nwegwe goes to the line.
N-W-I-G-W-E. I'm glad you're here with me.
Seventeen to 4 run. And a 22-13 lead. In the corner. 5 field goals in all for the first half. Crossover. Fisher. Bounce pass.
Well, look at the reaction defensively by this team. That is exceptional. Really well prepared, to handle the dribble drive, contain the penetration. And we've seen them do it against a lot of people, but these struggles, layups around the rim. King had an opportunity, cross-court passes, playing the passing lane. Terrific reaction on rebounds, pulling the string on runners. Just not themselves, attributable to excellent performance by Robert Morris.
Corey Stokes at the line where he excels. He's an 88% free throw shooter for the year. He gets the first of two. That foul was on Elijah Thompson, number 35. So Mike Rice going deep into his bench. Those of you who follow Villanova know that Jay Wright will use 10, 11 players, no problem.
And the talent level matches too.
Yeah.
In some cases, you know, guys really committing to step up the performance. This is where they're going to win at Villanova. Maybe a little more basic this trip. Straight up, good containment.
Delton Jones, number three. Back it goes to Russell Johnson. He's guarded by Scott Reynolds.
Not a bad pull-up guy either. Wow, can he drill it, huh?
Oh!
He is playing with some confidence. That pull-up, usually 15, 70-foot J. That one a little deeper.
He's a freshman out of Chester, PA, in the Philly area. Reynolds.
Ooh, good defense.
They're going to get Elijah Thompson, number 35, for his second quick foul.
And well, you've got the size and the ability to plumb Bob. Just another couple inches, he would have had three. But you're right about the confidence level. And defensively, they're in the right spot. I thought that was just a play on. Scotty hit the belly, goes to the floor. Just let him go.
One more for Scott Reynolds. Well, I fully realize it's early. 4:36 to go first half. But this game is reminding me of one of the most famous 15 against 2, Richmond over Syracuse in 91.
Too far for you.
Mike Rice in his third year as the head coach at Robert Morris. 3 years starting guard at Fordham. Robert Morris leading by 8 to 15 seed over a 2 seed in big part, in large part, Bill, because they've out-rebounded Villanova 17-5 so far.
They're aggressive. They're prepared. Excellent defense. Everybody knew that coming in. And yet selectively biting them with their offense, too. Just breaking through traps and taking the extra pass. The one dribble pull-up jumper has been effective.
Scotty Reynolds will take a seat on the bench, and Malik Wayans will replace him. Wayans started this game. Scotty Reynolds did not, nor did Corey Fisher. Jay Wright, the head coach, saying he wanted to make a minor teaching point. So he did not start either Reynolds' All-American or Fisher. They both were out for about 4 minutes. And I would stress it's the minor part, but you think maybe it had an impact on this.
Well, you know, Robert Marsh is playing great. There's no question about it. But also, it's upset. Look at this, Penetrant. What helps?
Hello.
That one's up on the hill with all the good Italian restaurants. I wish we could afford them. Dribble drive. Say goodnight or late in the afternoon, huh? Good aggressive play by Green, though. That's the way to go at the rim, and they have not backed off Robert Morris. But finishing the thought, it sometimes throws you off as a group when discipline does occur, and it takes a while to get your wheels.
Well, they have looked lethargic. They're not hitting their shots. And in contrast, here's Robert Morris. That one doesn't go for Belton Jones. Quick on the run out, Wayans.
Oh, Wayans is such a terrific driver. I mean, he's got strength and blue box speed.
Second game here will be Richmond St. Mary's. We are in the South region, the ultimate destination after the visit to Providence would be a trip to Houston next week. Top seed in the region, Duke. Villanova's number two. And that one goes cold, and Villanova trying to climb back into this thing now. Taylor King will come back on. 3 minutes, 32 seconds to go.
Do you like this speed, Vern? Ooh, take it to the 10, young fella.
Up on the banners up. You don't believe me?
No, I just want to be sure.
That's his wife, Julie, to the left. I wouldn't mind getting both of them. Boy.
Oh,
Dave.
Oh, who's he talking about?
Dave Gavitt.
Oh, yeah, when they didn't go in 80, I think.
80,
yeah. Yeah, they didn't go. Remember the Carter?
He also started the Big East.
Wasn't it Vern?
Yes. Okay. Oh, yeah.
He was the voice of basketball.
Yep. That's great. Yeah. In attendance today, basketball royalty, Julie and Dave Gavitt. It's hard to limit the list of things you could say about Dave Gavitt, Big East commissioner, He was the head coach here at Providence, 69-79, Olympic coach, 1980. And not so coincidentally, the guy who recommended that Bill Raftery pursue a career in broadcasting.
Well, he watched my team play, and he said, you should get another career, kid. But also, this beautiful building is attributable to him. And the reason this tournament is here, Tom Jones said, saying one of the important reasons, obviously, the building, but Dave Gavitt and his impact on this great game.
How about that? I thought he'd established himself.
And away from the rim, too.
Yes, it wasn't under the basket. This March, please fill out your census form and mail it back. I just read what they put in front of me. That was a surprise. Okay,
basically, you all count. But
yeah, that's right.
You know, when you think of this team and the flexibility that Jay Wright has, Wayne's a guy that can come in and spell or play with any of them. They've got different point guards. And you know, that is terrific to have that many extensions from the bench.
Russell Johnson. One more. 25-19, 3:14 to go before the halftime break. This has been an impressive effort by the Colonials of Robert Morris.
Very well prepared. Saw them yesterday going through their defensive drills. That's where he doesn't worry too much about the offense. That'll take care of itself. Mike Rice believes in this end of the floor. Watch the footwork, the spacing. Usually good help down there on the rake. Oh, they are solid.
Yes, indeed.
Pretty
no
good
numbers, but a beautiful feed. And then the shot they couldn't finish. Russell Johnson, number 34, at the other end. Here's Fisher, lost control. Gets it back. Look at the quick defense.
I love it. I mean, the hands are not giving up on it. Mike sort of pacing on the sideline, giving support. Oh, he's dying.
They called it a Messier Nwigwe, and that's going to send Fisher back to the free throw line.
They have not been able to attack that lane, Fisher and company. Reynolds either. Standing people up on the drive.
Scotty Reynolds is going to replace Fisher, so he stays on the sidelines. Neither Fisher nor Reynolds started the game today. A minor teaching point stressed by Jay Wright. He kept him out of the starting lineup, and he went for the donut.
Ooh, a 78% free throw shooter as well.
2:35 to go. Wayans.
Robert Morris has been taking good shots, a lot of ball screens, and therefore when you take good shots, you're in defensive balance, you're coordinated.
Look at those quick hands. And Wigwig saved it. Now left side. Russell Johnson, the redshirt freshman from the corner. And Wigwig.
Yes! He gets a little Wigwig going his way. A nice penetration and fine quick timeout by Villanova. How about the ball rolling and the activity around the glass, huh?
Wigwig.
I thought so. Yeah. He said Tippin.
No.
No, Monzie.
Oh.
Yeah, I thought it just rolled. Yeah.
Monday on CBS, TV comedy doesn't get any more awesome than this. Catch a new episode of How I Met Your Mother Monday, only on CBS.
And Vern, that last jump shot, defense is set. Counter that. This is a key period, I think, for Robert Morris, the next 2 minutes. Villanova probably will try and extend the defense a little bit, try and pick up the pace of the game.
Reynolds. Wow. Wow. I'm not so sure. Tried that shot over Dallas Green. Now they get it back. From the corner, Taylor King. Much better.
Why does that help? But he can step way out there. Wayne's with a terrific look. And here's the three-quarter court pressure. Got to value the ball now.
In Wigway, number two. Belton Jones, number three. 6-point margin with 1:20 to go first half.
Pretty good job banging the ball here. Great extension defensively by Villanova.
Shot clock at 6.
You don't want to foul. Move your legs at this point.
At 2.
Nice.
Rejected by Sutton.
The shot clock. Terrific effort. That's the type of defense you would expect from Villanova. Really got after it. Denying on the perimeter. Really aggressive to close out here.
Number 25. Big Sutton. One minute to go, first half. Ooh, dang, my goodness.
He doesn't mind those. That's he gets me nervous.
Wayne's almost lost it. In the lane.
Good control.
Back outside, King.
No good. You can tell. So he didn't catch it clean. What a half, huh, for Robert
Marsh? How about
that?
Colonials out of the Northeast Conference, 23-11. It's a 15 leading a 2, and they will have the lead at the half.
Oh, they over pursue here, but smart. You're not going to jack it up early.
See a couple of second different shot clock, play clock.
Wow.
King,
foul.
And a foul.
Not a good one either. Goodness, got to control yourself, Dallas Green.
That's his second.
Clock stops, ring the bell. They wanted the last shot. A little bit frustrating. Mike Rice really pacing on that sideline. He knows that that's a very harmful situation.
And that'll put Taylor King, a Californian who began his collegiate career at Duke, played there 1 year, transferred, sat out a year ago. And the free throw woes continue for Villanova. This is one of the strengths as a team is at the free throw line. They hit 75%, but today 6 of 10.
And this one's key because you want to set up your defense. They'll really get after them. Number Marsh, just value the ball. Don't turn it over. Very important. Well, doesn't matter.
They've missed their last four. But King gets the rebound and then can't control it.
Oh, he could have dribbled it.
Yes, he could have.
They're going to get one more shot. Catch and turn.
0.8 seconds left.
How about this play? Just over penetrating the hand. He could dribble or pass it. Anything he wanted. Just didn't really get a good look at the clock. Just executed.
Well, a year ago, Villanova down to American University by 10 at the half. And they are currently down 6.
Back screen to the big, looking for Sutton around the rim.
With a clean catch, it might have happened.
How about that, huh?
Yeah.
You've seen that before.
I have. Christian Lehner, where are you? That's the end of the first half, 28-22. Robert Morris will send you to Greg Gumbel with AT&T at the half after this message and this word from your local station.